Hi there, I'm Sean Doman. Today I'll be reviewing the new Fujitsu ScanSnap iX1600 and discussing some specific ways that it can be used as part of a home office setup. I've used Fujitsu products for the past decade or so, and in this review, I'll be breaking down how this product can benefit you and what kind of technology it has to improve your processes and efficiency. If you like this video, please be sure to like and subscribe at the end so that I can keep working with software and hardware makers to produce these kinds of reviews. As part of my mission to bring the best tech to my clients and colleagues, I'm continually in touch with different companies that make computer software and hardware. When it comes to scanners, Fujitsu scanners are some of my favorite, so I recently got in touch with a colleague at Fujitsu, and a few days later, she sent me this unit to review. Before I get started, please note that I'm not being paid by Fujitsu and that I'm giving an honest review. I reached out to Fujitsu because the company is a world leader in document imaging and has a well-earned reputation for quality and reliability. I also wanted to make this review because I know that many people are working from home these days and that it's very important to have a good scanner so that it's easier to work with documents and share them. Okay, so to get started, this is the Fujitsu ScanSnap iX1600. From what I can see, it's an attractive looking unit. It has a nice profile and looks professional on a desk in an office environment. It comes in white or black and has a great design and finish. This model just came out in January, and Fujitsu is already promoting it as the flagship model of the ScanSnap series. Given the success and popularity of the ScanSnap series, I'm very curious to see what it's going to be like. To start with one of the most noticeable features, the iX1600 has a touchscreen right on the front of the unit. What's great about this is that it isn't just a flashy interface that mirrors the software on your computer. By placing these controls directly on the front of the scanner through a touchscreen, Fujitsu has actually made this scanner work as a standalone unit. This is actually really useful and gives you a lot of power and ability to control the scanner right here on the touchscreen. You don't need to access it through software on a computer or other device, though it does of course work with PC and Mac, as well as smartphones and tablets running iOS and Android. So if you don't need a device to scan using the iX1600, you may be wondering, what does it do once it scans the documents? Well, because the iX1600 can connect wirelessly or directly access the cloud, it can either scan documents directly to a folder on your computer or to different cloud locations through services such as Google Drive, Microsoft OneDrive, QuickBooks Online, and many others. If I was using the iX1600 at my office and mostly scanning documents that are a standard 8.5x11 size, I'll select my profile and my scanned documents will go to the folder on my computer that I've configured. Another great thing about the touchscreen is that it can be used to control different user profiles so that many different people can use the iX1600. For example, if I'm in a small office, I can share access to the unit with my team, or if I'm at my home office and my family would also like to use it, I can configure up to 4 different user profiles, one for me and one for the other people, and we can even color code them. If I was in my office, each team member could use their own profile so that when they scan their documents, they'll go to their desired location. I should mention at this point that there is of course some setup involved to get the iX1600 up and running. Fortunately, setting up the scanner is really easy and all of the directions are provided on the unit itself. Once you plug it in, the touchscreen walks you through the steps. Select your desired display language, then select Next, then choose the startup mode. If I wanted the power to stay on when I close the cover, I'd go with Fast, but I'll go with Normal for now, and if I want to change this in the future, I can do this under the Settings tab. On the next screen, I'll select both, because I plan to use the iX1600 on my computer and on my mobile device. Next, I attach the unit to my computer using the USB cable and visit the ScanSnap website to download the software and continue with the setup process. This website is all about setting up the scanner for the first time. I'll click here to download the software and click through the end user agreements. Once the software is downloaded, I'll launch it and continue with the setup using the typical setup type settings. Note that if you're a Windows user, you may get a warning from your Windows Defender firewall. If you get this message, click where it says Allow Access. Select the i1600 model and then start setup. Follow the instructions to connect your ScanSnap to your computer if you haven't done so already. In a few seconds, the software will detect the scanner and tell you that the connection is complete. At this point, if your computer is also connected to your Wi-Fi, your wireless access point, you can connect to your ScanSnap unit through Wi-Fi so that you don't need to use the USB cable. Select Yes, and then Next, assuming that it's detected the correct network, and then Next, and Next again. Once the ScanSnap is connected through your Wi-Fi, the software will prompt you to unplug the USB cable from the scanner and from your computer. At this point, you can click here to return to the Fujitsu website to watch a short video tutorial. Once you're done, you'll be at the last screen in the configuration process, and you can click close. Open the ScanSnap Home app, and this is where you can control the scanner and the documents that you're scanning. This is also where you'll configure different user profiles and custom scan options. If you need more information, the Fujitsu ScanSnap US team has produced many great training videos which are on their YouTube channel. If you have any problems configuring your scanner, these videos should give you all of the information that you need. However, if you need any more information or if you're having any issues, please feel free to contact me directly so that I can make some more walkthrough videos as may be needed. Okay, so let's get into seeing how the iX1600 actually handles different scan jobs. To start, let's use this large pile of paper. Once I'm done with it, I can keep my working space clean by filing these documents away in a folder, which I'll then put in a filing cabinet for storage. I'll simply insert the documents face up, and either from the touchscreen or from the software on my PC, I'll select Scan to Folder, and then I'll hit the big Scan button. Because my profile is already set up, this setting will scan to the folder that I've already configured. Next, I'll scan the documents again and conduct a little speed test. I've loaded the unit up to its maximum number of 50 pages, and I'll start the timer now. Okay, wow, it took about 70 seconds for it to scan 50 pages. That's pretty fast and should be good enough for most tasks. However, if you need something bigger and faster, Fujitsu has many different lines of scanners that increase in capacity and price. Okay, so what if a member of my family also wants to use the iX1600 to scan photos? No problem. After configuring a profile for her, she can select her profile, which is Chantel Home. She can then insert the photos, select Photo Album on the touchscreen, and then press Scan. Instead of scanning the photos as if they were documents and put them in my folder, the iX1600 will treat them as photos, scan them in full color, and then upload them to Chantel's Google Drive. There's also another cool setting, which is for cards and letters. It's similar to the setting for photos, except it will double-side the scans. Just be sure that the card is smooth and doesn't have any 3D objects on it, like glitter or anything like that. In addition to scanning documents, photos, and cards, many people will also find the iX1600 to be useful for scanning receipts, business cards, and plastic cards like IDs and credit cards. Before I try some scans, I'll install this little guide which comes with the iX1600 and helps with guiding in these kinds of smaller documents. Now that it's installed, I'll scan this Starbucks receipt using the ScanSnap app on my smartphone. Once I connect through the app, the front of the iX1600 will show that it's connected to my mobile device. Once I scan the receipt, it'll appear in the app and be stored on my phone and on the cloud. This will come in really handy, because if I ever want to see a receipt, I don't just want it to be in a shoebox somewhere. I want it to be on my smartphone and on my laptop. This is also really helpful for business cards. For example, here's one of my old business cards. In one scan, I can get color as well as both sides of the card. Assuming that I'm happy with the scan, I can rename the file and keep my business cards organized. As with receipts, it's much more useful to have my business cards on my phone instead of in a drawer in my desk. Similar to scanning business cards, another feature of the iX1600 that I'm really excited to try is the option to scan hard plastic cards, like IDs and credit cards. Taking a scanned copy of an ID is a normal business practice for many of us, and until now, it's always been something that I've had to do using a flatbed scanner. Instead of using a real ID, I'll use my grocery store points card here as our example. This is the first time that I'm trying this, so here goes. Cool, okay, that was awesome. And the result of the scan looks great. This is going to be a really handy feature for a lot of people. Another feature that I stumbled upon while testing this unit was this dust detection feature. In preparation for running tests, I'd been building up a pile of paper which I was planning to scan. When I was scanning some of the older pieces of paper, the dust detection screen came up and walked me through the process of opening the cover and cleaning the glass with a cloth. Once I finished cleaning, I closed the cover and the unit told me that the glass was clean. Although this is a small feature, it's this kind of attention to detail that I think has earned Fujitsu their reputation for quality and reliability. Okay, so there you have it. That's my review of the Fujitsu ScanSnap iX1600. I spent quite a bit of time using it while making the review, and I found that it's another high-quality Fujitsu product. It's a very well-designed and well-built unit that helps with accomplishing all kinds of important scanning tasks. By scanning papers, photos, receipts, and cards, you can reduce paper clutter, increase storage space, and increase efficiency when it comes to dealing with and sharing digital documents. The iX1600 is simple to set up, easy to use, and scans documents quickly. A desktop scanner is a must for any office nowadays, and if you're going to have one, I think that you probably can't go wrong by using the flagship model of the ScanSnap series. Depending on where you look, you should be able to find new models going for anywhere between about $500 and $650. If you're interested in buying one, I have a promo coupon code through Fujitsu, which will provide you with a discount and give me a referral fee. Please just get in touch with me and I'd be happy to provide the code. Thanks again for watching. If you liked this video and found it to be helpful, please leave a like, comment, follow, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have a request for a future review, please just let me know and I'll do my best to make it happen. As always, I'm Sean Dellman.